Roach are without doubt one of the most iconic species in the whole of the UK. They're probably the first species you ever encountered. Catching a small roach and setting alight that passion for angling, no matter whether you fish on rivers, canals, reservoirs, commercials, park lakes, or anything in between, roach are bound to be present. Now, where it becomes tricky catching roach is when we look at size. Most of us have caught roach up to maybe a pound. Anyone who's caught a 2-pound roach is a very lucky person. And there are very few people that have caught a 3-pound plus giant. In truth, there aren't many waters with them. Those waters that do have them are often vast reservoirs where the fish acts like a needle in a haystack trying to find them. This water behind me is 1 acre in size, it's open to a day ticket, and it's home to a 3-pound plus roach along with plenty of other backup fish in the 2-pound bracket. The man behind us knows all about this place. So let's go and have a word with him and he'll tell us exactly where we are and exactly how you can be in with a chance of catching one of these absolute giants. So this is Mykie Pollard, the venue manager of
Alvechurch Fisheries.
Tell us where Alvechurch Fisheries and tell us a bit about the complex.
Yeah, Alvechurch is in between Alvechurch itself and Bark Green. We have 5 lakes here. We've got the 3 match lakes, Horseshoe, Arrow and the Canal Lake. And then we've got the new specimen lake, which is Roe Lake. That you can only book that through the lodges, so you need to speak to the bosses on that bit. And then you've got this lake, which is the house pool, which is some special lake, I must admit.
There is some very special fishing here. Before we get into that though, tell us a little bit about the history of this lake.
So yeah, it was dug out about 20 years ago. And then about 10 years ago, 2014, it got drained, fish got took out and then reshaped, so to what it is now. A lot of the roach and stuff in here were obviously, everything was took out. And then it got stocked back in and they weren't that big really. I think they were big as about 0.5 pound back then.
And it's fair to say quite a few of them packed some weight on, aren't they?
Yes, definitely. I mean, this used to be the actual specimen lake itself. So before we had the new big lake and obviously all the carp anglers used to fish this. So they're putting all the essential cell bawley in, the fishery feed pellet, which is the high protein, the Alaqua Best. It's what we use here. And they just got big on it. Obviously the carp anglers were putting it in and the roach just got bigger and bigger and bigger. And they really have put some weight on.
And the guys always knew they had some big roach in here because they were reported, Mike has been in court himself, but you never knew exactly what was in here until a couple of months ago when you put the nets through. Tell us about what you found when you did that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we did think we had a 3-pound in here, but it's never been caught. So, you know, you weren't never 100% sure. We knew there was some special 2-pounders in here, the odd pound and a half. But when we netted it, we couldn't believe it, what we found. I mean that we had a 3-pound, three pound roach. And, you know, we weighed it properly as well. We were proper like doing it again and again to double check. And it definitely was 3-pound, three.
It's not on its own though, is it? If you don't catch a 3-pound roach, How many twos did you find roughly?
20, about 20 to over 2 pounds. There was some really incredible. Still, there was some pushing close to 3 pounds, you know, 2 pound 12. And then you've got roach between 0.5 pound to 1.5 pounds. And there's a lot of pounders in here. They're just a nightmare to catch sometimes. You just don't understand. You think they're not in here. And then when we netted it, wow.
Incredible.
Honestly, you couldn't catch your breath.
And the great thing is you're never going to be far away from the potential of a fish of a lifetime, because the lake's only 1 acre, isn't it?
Yeah, you're never too far away. I mean, since I've been here, I have never seen that 3-pound roach caught ever. So, you know, it is a chance of a lifetime. But even if your personal best is 0.5 pound, you've definitely got every chance to beat that in here without struggle.
Absolutely. And we came here last year, the first time we had a look at those roach. And you said, I reckon we've got a chance of roach. And you had two, which were just under £2 apiece. Yeah. And that was one heck of a day. I think we had our heart in our mouths several times. And I think high-pitched squeals were like, it's a roach, don't lose it. It was incredible.
We did get a bit giddy, didn't
we? A little bit, just ever so slightly. Thankfully, there was no cameras rolling that day, so you wouldn't have seen how giddy we were, but it was incredible.
How girly we were.
Oh, massively. We really, really lost the plot with it. And thankfully, we got those fish in. Tell us a little bit about the contours of the lake, about depths, and how many pegs are roughly on it.
So there's roughly, probably, I would say, about 20 pegs. But, it's 20 pegs, but it'll be tight.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot, there's like four corners on the lake where you couldn't have your friends all around you because there's no space. But in general, good 12, 14 anglers is quite comfortable, especially if you're silverfish fishing and you want to go for them bigger stamper silvers. The depth in here, in the middle, about 9.5, 10 foot. And it's, you've got to imagine the house pools are bowled. So everything slopes down into the middle, all the way around the whole lake. Obviously, some are shallower than others. So you've got, where we are now, it's a bit more shallow as it goes down. But on the other side, on the disabled pegs, it's a lot deeper. And it drifts down a lot steeper.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And if those roach don't feed, there's some brilliant backup fishing.
Oh, definitely.
Big bream and perch and even the odd tench. And as I said, there's double figure carp in it. This lake's, it's got everything, hasn't it?
It's got everything. I mean, the bream, I mean, people that know me know I love my bream fishing. And, you got bream up to £8 in here. And you've got every chance of catching a 5-6 pounder in here. But the backup bream as well, they go up to 2-2.5 pounds. There's loads of skimmers, about £1, £1.5. You know, it's got everything in here. The perch as well, they go up to about £2.5, I think. We've seen one come out. And even that, the tension here to £5. Now, there isn't a lot of tension here. We have started trickling some in out the stock ponds. The ones we caught have put on, they're about £2 now. So there is the odd tension here. You know, if you want to come tench fishing, you have to work hard at that.
Absolutely.
You know.
But still, that idea of a mixed lake, 1 acre lake, and you're in with a chance of some really special fish. And every time that float goes under, you just don't know what it could be. But one thing I've found out just working with Mykie down here is the way you fish for it. It isn't traditional roach tactics. And in a minute, he's going to show us the tactics and the bait that you need to use down here. Because it's quite unique the way you need to fish it and how you can put yourself in pole position to try and catch one of those massive roach. So when you think of big roach, you may be thinking maggot feeders, wagglers, stuff like that. Oh, pole fishing here for you, isn't it, mate?
Pole fishing.
Why? 100%. Why the pole?
I just think it's a bit more accurate, really. I've tried the waggler, the feeder on here, I don't know how many times, and for some reason can't get it to work. I know a lot of people have done the same thing. It's just, I don't think they're used to that style of fishing. In the summer, definitely, but in the winter, this looks fantastic as a waggler venue on, if you... a traditional waggler match angler who loves fishing a waggler, it's perfect for it. But where the fish are at the moment, they're not used to that style of fishing, and it's just dominating in the pole really at the moment.
They're used to taking bait off the bottom, aren't they? Finding beds of bait that carp anglers have left behind. Unlike a lot of traditional roach waterway, a lot of casters, a lot of maggots are fed. Doesn't really happen here so much at the moment. So they're used to finding scraps from carp, aren't they?
Yeah, that's what it is. And the key is on here is your depth. You've got to find them in what depth of water. At the moment, it's 5 foot. I think we've established that already today, haven't we?
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely 5 foot of water. You will catch them in the deep water, but they just don't want to be there. It's too cold. They want to be in the warmer layers at the moment. And you would think, again, on the waggler, you would think, I'll get that right. It doesn't really happen that often. I've seen a couple of people manage to do it, but I think it's just been on a warmer day. They wanted to be up in the water a little bit, but it's very hard to try and get in pole. At the moment, it's dominating.
Okay, mate. So, we've established that. Now, you can fish a pole, and if you don't get your rigs right, you ain't going to get a bite. Got two top kits here, mate. Talk me through these rigs, and talk me through everything. Elastic, mainlines, floats, the lot.
Yeah. Wow, so start from the top then. Obviously, it's the elastic itself is the new fish 6-8 zip, and with the beads on now because I've gone off the Dacons.
Yeah.
Got a little matte pot just the smallest one you can get, just to control your feeding, how much I'm putting in. Okay, definitely a back shot is an absolute must. I think I can't stress that enough, really. And then we got down to the new fish, Cypri, 4x12, okay, and a wire stem. It's the nitty wire now, is it? That's what they call it.
That's right. What mainline have you run that on?
So this is a 5-pound mainline.
Yep.
Okay, and then if we get down to the bottom for the hook, I'll just explain the shots in a minute, which is an 010, Drennan 010 hook. Nice and light and simple. So the main line's really irrelevant.
What size is that hook?
Size is 18.
Size
on
18.
That one.
So nice and fine down that bottom end, as you
nice
expect.
And fine.
Run through that shot in.
Shot in. So because, you know, you think when you're roach fishing, you would lay it in, you know, nice and slowly, pinging caster or maggot. You know what I'm saying? So you're picking them up as they come up from the water. In here at the moment, they're not doing that. And again, when we go back to what we said earlier, they just want to be on top of the bait, grazing, just sat there on top of it. So so basically, it's now it's more of a lift and drop rig. I want to keep it still, just a little bit of wind. That's why we've got the wire on there. Okay, and then I've got a nice bulk shot, all number 10s, because it's 4x12, the whole lot is number 10 through.
Yep.
7 number 10s. Okay, and I think I've got one number 11 dropper just to fine tune it.
So you've got the bolt there, yeah. Then a couple of little droppers.
A couple
below.
Droppers there, and you can see now what's that, nearly 2 foot from the bolt to there. So I want it to go through really slow. And you watch that float, it'll sit up, and then it should go really slow down, and it'll just sit there perfect.
And I'd imagine with that, what you'll get is those fish will be on the bottom, the rig will fall through,
yeah.
And then all of a sudden, they will see that coming through at slow pace. And then they hit the bait just as it touches down.
They hit the bait, but when it lands, and if you don't hit the bait, you give it a couple minutes, and then what you do is you lift and then drop it down. But when you drop it down, you just drop it straight down. You don't, you know, some people just lower it in. Just drop it down, let the two dropper shots just take hold of the float, and you'll see all of a sudden it'll just go like that. And then you know it's working. And normally, if they're there, they'll have it within 30 seconds to a minute. And if we're really on it, they will take it pretty much. And you can time it as well.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So what's the other rig? How does this one vary?
This one is just slightly deeper. It's pretty much the same rig.
Yeah.
This one is, I've just stepped up a little bit because I know the bream sit on the lines, which we're going to show you today. So this is a 8-10 new fish sip as well. Okay, two back shots. I've got on this one, okay, and then it goes down to F1 fine 4x14. It's more of a carbon float, stem float. So ideally, what I wanted to do at the start today is just fish through the water, do exactly what it is on the said on the tin. But like again, if you go down, it's not happening. I do try it all the time, you know, but it's not happening. I've gone straight back to the bulk shot underneath. And then two droppers again, exactly the same setup really. 5-pound mainline, 2-pound bottom, or 010s, everyone in it. But I've actually now just changed over to size 20. That reason is it's just pinging off a bit, and I just think I need to just come down a little bit.
Awesome.
But still 010, still the same thing.
So the key with this is get that rig down to the bottom quickly. Yeah. But also, once it gets near the bottom, let it flutter in that little bit, because even though those fish are on the bottom, they see it, and if it comes in too fast, I guess.
Yes,
that's
definitely.
It. Game over.
If it
over.
Comes in too fast, you're not getting a bite. You've really got control of that fall. And just mess about with your shotting pattern as well. If you need to bring your bulk down even further, bring it down, mess about. Because if you'll just sit, you've got to get that bait slow. But if they pop it on it, get the bulk shot down.
Get it. So
get it down, get it to the bottom, and they will have it.
Awesome. Right, that's rigs done. And bait, you'd usually think we'd be talking casters, maggots, which they are, they're here. But you'd also think that things like fish meal, ground baits and pellets wouldn't come anywhere into the equation. That'd be wrong, wouldn't it?
It would be definitely wrong, yes. The bait, I mean, couldn't keep it any simpler here, really, on this lake. Corn is another one I would definitely use sometimes. At the moment, I don't tend to use it. I know people have caught on it. I don't tend to use it yet. I wait until spring. When it warms up a bit, corn for bream, and the big roach, they'll pick that up straight away. But you just got your traditional maggots. I've gone for more whites lately than I have reds. I tend to be catching a lot more roach on the white at the moment. I'm not normally a white fan, really. I fish a lot of red maggot, but I found in here that whites on the right day just working really well.
And you're putting them in with some pellets as well, aren't you? Some micro pellets.
it's you know, again, like we said about the carp, because it used to be a carp lake, they're so used to coming on all over bait. And I think they're just so tuned into the pellet. And like on most lakes, you know, you'll catch roach on that with that.
That's the sort of combination.
Simple, innit?
And you even got expanders for, I guess, are they mainly for the skimmers and stuff like that, for the bream?
At the moment, if you want to catch the bream, you'll catch them on ground bait, which we'll go through in a minute. Just get rid of that. Go for the ground bait, but expander and pellet, expander and micro in here at the moment is deadly.
And I bet you do pick an odd big roach up on that because of the way they feed.
Yeah, you do. Not very often, if I'm honest. I think once them bream are there, they tend to push the roach out of the way because it's just quality bream. And I've been doing the damage on here with expander. 6mm, 4mm, and just swap and change. You know, find what they want in a day. I found at the moment 6mm working better than 4s. Why, I don't know. I don't think anyone would answer that question. And with your micros. And then what I do tend to do now is caster, and I'll actually feed caster, maggot, and pellet together. And every now and again, and then I can change hook bait as well, which is the main one. I can go off, I feel like a couple of casters on there, or a caster, and then you will might pick up the odd big roach as well.
And this is your mix of, so we've got So Simple Fine Roach and So Simple Black Magic Gold. 50-50?
No, 50-25.
50-25, and then you have a little bit of, and then you put some additive in with that as well.
Yeah, got some Fluoro Crush, which I think has actually worked today. If I'm really honest, it's the first time I've used these all together. The BMG, it's fantastic. It's really weird because I used to order this about a year ago and I stopped using it because I didn't use ground bait a lot. And I have found some old stuff, come on here, some old BMG, and I had a blinding day on it. And this is a new one I'm finding, but it's working. We'd had a couple of roach, so I know that works.
Yeah.
And I'm trying this and it's obviously doing the damage today.
Bit of colour.
And definitely works.
Awesome.
100%.
Well, I think we've been chatting a bit too long.
Yes.
There's a lake with a 3-pound roach here. I think it's time we get them rigs in the water and we can have a chat while he's trying to find that 3-pound roach. As he said, not yet been caught, so.
Fingers crossed.
Who knows? Who knows? Let's get fishing.
Let's get fishing.
I got down to fishing and there's a few different lines on the go today. As Mikey touched on before, there's a depth of water that they find is working well at the moment, but the pegs on the hole, they give you options. I mean, talk us through what sort of depths you've got. I mean, what if you fish short and then you fish long, what sort of depths are you looking at, Mikey?
So on this side specifically, really, you're looking at 14.5 metres, you're looking at 7-8 foot. 11 metres, 5.5 and a half. And then, I mean, I'm fishing at 13, but I'm fishing right at an angle and I've got the same depth that I have at 11 in front. So again, that's 5 foot. And then short on your 2+2, at least 2.5, 3 foot, give or take. And I'm fishing on the slope, so it goes away from me.
So, as you can tell from that, it is really, really important to get that plumb on and have a good plumb around, because it's not a flat bottom, it's a sloping down. As Mikey explained before, it's a bowl shape and you need to work out the contours. So what have you fed on that line now then? How do you top up these lines? That's the one thing I'm intrigued about.
So on this line, I've done ground bait, maggot, and I've just started introducing a little bit of caster. I tend to, every time I get a bite, I feed straight away. So in the little cad pot, as I said earlier, just feed a little bit. As soon as I get a bite, land the fish, feed again straight away. I don't hold back. You definitely got to put feeding in no matter what. It's not one of them where you've got to fish negative. You've got to be really positive when you fish on this lake, because they just come to bait. They, you know, don't matter what time of year it is, you can fish here when it's been minus one the night before and you still got to put the bait in.
Yeah.
But you won't catch if you just start being negative. And you just be positive in all three lines. I've put, what, four balls on this now.
And what are you talk about three lines. So you've got your line there. Where are your other two then?
So 30 metres to my left. Yep. I've got one right in front of me at 11 metres, which is the same depth, which is perfect. And I do have a short line on my 2+2, which are my three main lines. And I have been feeding that short line, but I haven't been on it yet.
The one thing to remember is that this is specimen fishing. He's fishing for big roach and bream. Now, that does mean there will be sessions where you don't catch the fish that you're after. With 22-pound roach in the lake, you're not going to catch a 2-pound roach every time. You're certainly not going to catch the 3-pounder every time. It's never been caught. It's just been found and weighed properly. It's proper specimen fishing. But we're on a 1-acre lake, so you are never, ever far away. And there is no greater chance of doing it, I don't think, than coming down here and putting that giant roach in the net. So it's really important to put it into perspective when you come down here. You're not going to blank, because I said there are breams to go fall back on, perch to fall back on, smaller roach to fall back on, which are sort of anywhere from 6 ounce up to a pound. So there are bites to be had as well, but there's not many small fish in here, really tiny ones. They did when they did the netting, and we're in again. Here we go. What are we talking?
I think that's a roach. The way it's put, just playing a bit, but
we'll just have a look at what this. We'll have a look at what this fish is.
I think it is.
It'll be. It will not be a little blip. It will be something that needs the landing net. And every time the float goes under, the excitement is there of what it could be. What is it?
It is a roach.
We got a quality roach.
Got a, yeah.
Look at that. Look at that. I'll tell you what, hold that up for the camera, mate.
There we go. That's what we're talking
about,
mate.
That is what we're on about. And look at that. Even when you're not landing a 2-pounder, just hold that up. Show that to the camera for us, mate.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Proper.
That's pushing a pound. And there's loads of them in here. So if you want to come and be in with a chance of catching a monster roach whilst catching some beautiful stunners in the middle, get down to Alvechurch, get on the house pool, use Mikey's tactics, and you'll have a fantastic day and put you in with a chance of getting a fish that will get on the front cover of Angling Times.